day, I had an evening of friends that were all interdisciplinary in many ways, scientists and artists. And we were at dinner, and somebody said, this is a salon. And what is a salon? A salon is something that goes back into history. Have any of you heard of Gertrude Stein? How many have? Isn't that interesting? Because Gertrude Stein was a very important woman in America who created collections of some of the best art in all the world and in America. She, her sister was a physician, interestingly enough. And she lived in Paris. And she collected people about her, such as Picasso. And they sat around and they had intellectual discussions. There were scientists and artists together. And because of the discussions, each one of those people who were in the top of their world really got better in what they were doing. And we began to do it. Diana is a lawyer and an artist. And the other person that is not here is Dr. David Spangler. Do any of you know Dr. David Spangler?
With Lovewell.
Right.
Yes.
He's part
David
of Lovewell.
David is the third of our film.
And he's a professor here in performance art. One of the themes was, what is the difference between art and science? And it's something you'll think about. And we may talk about that later. Another was, how can this salon teach people who have cancer to live life better? And then we did a salon with returning veterans from Iraq and Afghanistan. And we did another salon with Muslims in America. And so here we are, you're all high school students, is that correct? And you're thinking about your future. And I'm learning from you.
I asked Wilma to be here today. Wilma and I have known each other, as she said, for a number of years now. Actually, we've worked together for about 8 years, starting projects. But Wilma has been a mentor for me. And I think it's very important in life that you have people that you find that can mentor you, because those are the people that can help let you make your own decisions, but have experience that can sort of help you formulate a direction in your life that you want to go. And that's part of what we're doing today. That's what the Aim Higher camp is about. You all recognize that you wanted to do more after last year. So I asked Wilma to be here, and she literally flew in from New York to be here for this and is flying out right after. So thank you, Wilma, very much, because that's what a good friend does. But
well, I care about education.
That's above and beyond. But anyway, Wilma is being modest in that she has, she developed the arts-related and humanities-related curriculum with Columbia University in New York. She's worked with hospitals in New York. Wilma has an amazing, amazing background. And how I met her is that she was on the board for the Museum of Art here in Fort Lauderdale. And when I started working to look at developing curriculum for the medical school, at NSU, they brought Wilma to the table, and that's how I met her. And she's been a mentor and friend basically ever since. So we have a real opportunity today, and from now on, this isn't really so much about us. I wanted to give you a little background about us,